Hello and welcome to another episode of Exploring Invertebrates. Today I'm going to be looking at the very complex lives of aphids, more specifically the relationship between aphids and the plants that feed them to the ants that farm them. So stay tuned, I'll see you on the other side. What you need to know about aphids is that they have extremely complicated life cycles. Some adult females tend to be wingless, while others winged. Some reproduce on their own without even getting fertilized and give birth to live young, while others just happen to lay eggs. So what exactly is happening here? This is a typical example of a lupin aphid colony that solely feeds and lives off the lupin plant. Throughout the summer period, the lupin aphid colony will predominantly consist of wingless adult females called stem mothers. Stem mothers such as this one are able to reproduce on their own without the help of a male and give birth to live young that are also wingless. Over time though, the colony will experience surplus growth and will eventually overpopulate this particular lupin plant. As soon as this happens, new offspring within the colony will begin to develop into winged adults and will be able to migrate to new, uncolonized lupin plants. What is also very fascinating about aphids is the relationships they form with other organisms. Aphids secrete a sugary, sticky waste product called honeydew, and they do this by tapping into the plant's main vessels and by feeding off plant sap. The honeydew secretions form the basis of many of their mutualistic relationships. Many species of ants tend to farm aphids, collecting their honeydew and protecting them in return, keeping them well fed and safe.